Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to this new episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher and today I want to show you all the different ways that you could manage your Azure resources. Whatever you are running on Linux, Mac or Windows, that you are on the go or always at your desktop, there's plenty of ways to manipulate or manage your Azure resources. Today, I want to show you the 5 ways that you could manage your resources. Of course, every way has these pros and cons, but let's get started with the first one, the Azure portal. Of course, the Azure portal is fantastic, is the by default option when you want to know more about a resource or if it's just the first time and you're looking around. So here I am in the portal, so it's portal.azure.com, and by the way, all the link I will mention will probably appear in the screen, and of course they will be available down below in the description. So I'm in the Azure portal, it's very convenient. You could search here with the search bar anything that exists that you would like to create or that you want documentation about. So this search bar is really, really powerful. But let's say I want to create a storage. So a very easy way, I could click this button here, create resource. Most of the time people will refer to the green plus button in the top left corner. So you click here and then you have the Azure Marketplace. And this is awesome. You have tons of ways to see all your things and you can manipulate those like this. So let's say, for example, I want to create a storage account. So we'll go scroll, I have a category here, so we'll click storage, and now I just want the default one. Voila, I will pick my subscription, create a name, create a new resource group. Resource group are just logical group, so it's easy that way to deploy a bunch of resources together to keep them all together to maybe do some reports or something like that. And when you want to delete, you could delete the resource group and all the resource inside that resource group will be deleted also. That's pretty convenient. And then we just need to give it a name, so that's cool. And I will keep the other resources by default. I click review, it check some validation and now create to create the resource. Very easy. Now I just need to wait for a few minutes and my resources would be created. Voila, the resource is created. So let's go jump into the resource. So now I'm in the resource blade and it's always the same pattern. On the left, I have many different options for every property I have for that specific resource. So for every resource, that could be different. Some will be the same, but some will be different. So always have a look. And again, don't spend your time scrolling and scrolling. If you're searching for something, let's say I want to export an ARM template for this specific resource, I don't need to search export. I could go here in the top and search export, and right away I will have it, export template, very convenient. And then I could explore all the property of my resource. And that will be the same for all the resources that you have deploy. So really, really, really easy. There's always documentation. Most of the time it will be in the last option. So you have like the resource health, new support requests if you want something. There's documentation available, quick start also. So see here, there's plenty of tools to help you get started with different language. So a lot of information. The portal is really packed with a bunch of options. Definitely an option to check. If you are interested to learn more about the portal and how it can help you to manage all the resources and also a little bit about the other option I will cover, there's an excellent Learn module in the Azure Fundamentals, so Microsoft Learn. It's there, really well done, very convenient if you prefer reading instead of watching a video. So the second option I want to talk is the Azure PowerShell. So of course, it's nice when we do the first VM or the first thing we deploy to the portal, it's really easy, it's visual, it's nice, but you know, when we want to deploy things, we most often will script things. So there's plenty of options here, but the first I want to talk about, and there's no priority here, just like I'm picking one, it's the Azure PowerShell. So in this page on the documentation, they will explain how to install it. And by the way, PowerShell now run on any OS, so very convenient. So here it will have information to install, update, and stuff like that. And if you go on reference, it will give you by resource type everything you should know to create, manage all the resource. Let's have a look. So I'm here in my terminal, Windows terminal, by the way. You should definitely look at that if you're on Windows. And let's say I want to create a new Azure storage. So I will do here the new AZ resource group because I still need the resource group, and I will create it in the East US. So here you see it's very convenient. It's always the same thing with the verb, and then I have the resource, the name I want, and I have auto completion. So if I want to know exactly what are the other property, I could do dash and then tab, and I will have all the other property. But for now, for us, this is enough. So we'll create the resource. It takes only a few seconds. Creating a resource group is very fast. So now what I want to do is create that account storage. So let's do this. So I want a new, same thing, a new AZ storage account. I specify the resource group that I just create, and I pass the name, the SKU I want, and location. Once again, only a few minutes, it will create the resource, and I will have my information. And voila, now my resource group is created. And if I want to query them and have more information about different resource, and I'm not talking only about storage resource, about other also, but here I'm just keeping the thing we're creating. So I could definitely do something like get AZ storage account, and I will receive a list of all the storage account that exists in my subscription. So this way you could create many different resources. When you do a get, go specific, put that in a variable, and build a very interesting script. So PowerShell is really great, well integrated in the Windows environment, but maybe that's not where you come from. So something else would be better for you. So that's why Azure CLI exists. And Azure CLI, just like PowerShell, will be cross-platform. So whatever platform you are, Azure CLI will work. If we go here on that web page, that's the start of the documentation, the overview, you will have all the instruction to install, update, or uninstall any version that you want. And then if we go again in the reference section, we'll have, just like in PowerShell, all the information we want by resources. So let's say I want to know more about the resource group. How do I create one? Here we'll have a bunch of example, and it's exactly like that for every resources, both in PowerShell and CLI. But since we are in CLI, let's see how we can create a Azure storage. So we'll switch back to my terminal. Here I am. Of course, I'm already logged in, but once you are, you could just create a new resource. In this case, I want to create a, you saw that coming, right? A resource group, of course. So AZ for Azure CLI, and then I say I want the object group, and I want to create one. I specify the name and the location. I run this, it takes only a few seconds, and I will retrieve my resource group. Voila, just like that. Now let's say I want to create a storage. What I can do is, here again, I want to do again the AZ, specifying the Azure CLI storage, because it's the object I want this time to create. It's not a group, it's a storage. And it's storage account, because in storage you have multiple sub object or sub resources. So I want a storage account, I want to create a new one. I will give it a name, I specify the location, and again the resource group that we just created. So if I execute this, it will take maybe a minute, maybe a little bit less, and I will have my resource. And voila! Just like that, I have my storage account created. As you notice, the return object is a JSON document, so very convenient. So now, if I want to query and see all the other resources I have, let's go on top of the screen. What I can do is AZ storage account, and instead of creating this time, I want a list. And here I specify the output by this dash O. And at any time, let's say I don't know what I'm looking for, I could do dash H for help. And I will have all the information about the property I could do. So the dash O for output specify that I want the output formatted in a table way. It's a little bit easier to read than a big JSON document. So here I said just a little bit. Just that my font is really big, Well, can I make it smaller maybe? So if I make it smaller, voila! If I make it super smaller, you see it's a table. There's a lot of information there. You know, stay to the end, I will show you a nice trick to format the output. Another interesting way to manipulate your resource, to manage your resource, when you're on the go and you just want to see, you receive a notification, maybe you need to restart a VM or something like that, you just want to see some logs or like see some information, there's a very useful thing that we all carry that could help you. And I'm talking about your phone. So here it is. The quality of the image right now is not good, but trust me, it is very pretty. I will try to do something else to make it prettier. So here we are in the Azure application, and I see right away I have my resource group, I can see the service health, I have my money down in the bottom, and I could go in my resource group, and now I have all the resource group I create, and we see here I have the resource group that we name Cloud 5-Minute, and I will see my storage account just there. So right away I could jump like that. Of course I don't see a long session available there, but you know, just for a quick check or for a deployment or see if the deployment was done successfully or maybe see the error of the deployment, I think it's really convenient to have the phone application. So the phone application is available on many different OS. Just check in your App Store. So the last options I want to show you is the Cloud Shell. This is really interesting because it's accessible from anywhere as long as you have access to internet. So you could access it through shell.azure.com. It's also available, let's switch to the portal, in the top right corner, there's a button here where you could have the Cloud Shell splitting the screen with the portal if you want, but for a longer experience, a longer session, I suggest to go at shell.azure.com. So here you have you can have a session in Bash or PowerShell, the way you want, just like it. And it will create a storage. So here I am in kind of my storage where I could save script and everything, I could install application. So I have my little environment there where I could have multiple stuff. And of course, right now I load the Bash, so I could run the same command we had previously. So Azure storage account list with the output table that we saw previously and expect the same result. But like I said, I will show you a trick to customize the output. So first let's clean that. So what you can do is instead of doing the output table, you could add a dash dash query, and then you specify all object and you want the property called name, and you will map name into it. And of course you could do the output again in a table. So this way you will only have the column you want, the name with the name you specify. Voila, much cleaner, right? So Azure CLI is very efficient because you could from any computer jump and feel just like home. You have your script, you have your tool, install. It's available from everywhere, and the beauty of it will keep everything from session to session. Very, very convenient. All the links are in the description. I hope you like this little video where I show you different alternatives. And for the big question, which one is the best? I think the portal, Azure portal, is definitely the first option when you are in the exploration mode. And then based on your background, the knowledge you have, pick your language, PowerShell or CLI of your choice. And then from where you run it, I think it just depends on the context. Are you on the road? Are you in your comfort of your computer? That's up to you. But know that those tools exist and they're there to help you. Thank you for watching. See you next time.